Oh, bless his name. Second Kings chapter 4, if you haven't said it, man. Second Kings chapter 4, beginning with the first voice. Now there cried a certain woman of the wives of the sons of the prophets unto Elisha, the wives of the sons of the prophets unto Elisha, saying, thou servant, my husband, is dead. And thou knowest that thou servant did fear the Lord. And the creditor is come to take unto him my two sons to be slaves, to be my men. And Elisha said unto her, what shall I do for thee? Tell me, what hast thou in the house? And she said, thy handmaid hath not anything in the house, but what?
A pot of oil.
Say, neighbor, that's enough.
Neighbor, that's enough.
With God. Yes, with God, that little pot of oil is just enough. Because he is a miraculous God. Is that right?
That's right.
Then he said, go, borrow thee vessels abroad of all thy neighbors, even empty vessels. Borrow not a few. In other words, borrow as many as you can. Is that right?
That's right.
And when thou art come in, thou shalt shut the door upon thee and upon thy sons, and shalt pour out into all those vessels, and thou shalt set aside thy wishes for. So she went from him and shut the door upon her and upon her sons, and brought the vessel to her, and she poured out. And it came to pass, when the vessels were full, that she said unto her son, bring me yet a vessel. And he said unto her, there is now a vessel more. And what happened?
The oil stayed.
The oil stopped. I said, neighbor, if I never had a problem, I would never know that God would solve that. Is that right? If you never had a problem, you will never know that God will solve them. First of all, before we go on with the message, I want to enlighten your mind that the whole scripture was given to us for instruction.
Amen.
For edifications. The whole Bible is said as a schoolmaster. A schoolmaster to teach, to lead, and to guide us. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So there are things and informations that are set forth in the Bible for our growth, for our education, for our guiding, to enable us to increase our faith in the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Is that right?
That's right.
In other words, the Bible is there to introduce who this God is to us.
Yeah.
And what he can do for us.
Yeah.
Somebody said, praise the,
praise the Lord.
So this woman, she was a wife of a good man. A wife of a son of a prophet. He was a PK. A good man that had the fear of God in him. Sometimes bad things happen to good people as well. Is that right? Somebody say, praise the Lord. Sometimes bad things happen to good people. God himself said that to us, that many are the affliction of the good people. Many are the affliction of the righteous. But God delivered the righteous from every affliction. This woman was good and she had a good husband. As somebody would say, he was a man that was good to his family. He was providing for his family. Hello. He had a positive J-O-B and he was negative HIV. He was negative STD. He was negative, come on now. He was negative demonic possessed. But he was good to his family. He was good to his wife. He was good to his two children. Somebody say, praise the Lord. But yet his life was cut short. But you will get to know that he was not the prophet. He was not a prophet. But he was just the son of the prophet. Hello? He was a student. He was student of the prophets. But he was a good man. Somebody said, praise the Lord. But it just happened that he passed away and left his wife with the two boys, the two children stranded. Somebody said, in dirt. In debt. Because if you find out later on, you will find out that when she approached the man of God, the prophet, when she approached the seer, Elisha instructed her to go borrow.
Yes.
Hello? Her explanations were, I want to take it step by step. Her explanation was that the burial was coming after her to take away her children to be slaves, to be bad men. That means to say that when her husband passed, her husband left her stranded in debt. Hello? So the creditors were coming after her. They were not coming after her for her stuff. They were not coming after her for her house or the things she possessed. Is that right? They were coming after her for what? For her children.
Right.
You can replace the stuff. If your car is repossessed, you can replace that.
Right.
Is that right?
Amen.
If your house is repossessed, you can find an apartment or you can find another house or a rental property. Those are just stuff that are made by men. But they were not coming after her stuff. They were coming after her children. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Somebody say, glory to God. Stuff can be replaced, but children cannot be replaced.
Amen.
Say, neighbor, stuff can be replaced. Is that right? They were coming after her stuff. But thank God that the man of God was around and she had a destiny with the man of God. Somebody say destiny. Remember now, this story is set among godly people, not outsider. It's set in the family of God. Her husband was a son of the prophet. She was a righteous woman. He was a righteous man. Hello? Righteous people can take loan as well. Because you got to give to Caesar what is Caesar, and you got to give to God what is God. Is that right? Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So now her husband had passed and left her with all these bills. And the creditor were coming after her to repossess, to possess her children, not her stuff. But thank God she had a destiny with the man of God. And I believe her husband that passed were working directly with Elisha. Because the woman went to Elisha and said that your servant, in other words, your students, that was my husband, you know how good he was. He was. He was a man of godly reputation. He had the fear of God in him. Somebody said, praise the Lord. So Elisha, knowing his responsibility to this woman, men of God, we have to know our responsibility to those that God sent unto us. We look at your attributes. We look at your contributions to the ministry. We look at your contribution toward the voice of God. And we watch over you as a watchman on the wall. Somebody say, praise the Lord. This woman had a good standing with Elisha. Her husband had a good standing with Elisha. And therefore, both of them have to have a destiny together. Somebody say, destiny. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say glory to God. She had a destiny with Elisha. Remember now, after the death of her husband, she did not go to any city council. She did not go to the mayor of the city. She did not go to the government of the she did not go to no politician at all. She went directly to the man of God. Because you don't know what the politician will do for you. They may just drag you around.
That's right.
Hello? They may send you to from one department to another, to one agency to another, and by the time you get through running, you are exhausted yourself. But the man of God had direct communication with God. Somebody say, praise the Lord. She had direct communication with God. And he did a little prayer, and God directed him what to do for the war. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Because the woman had destiny with him, and he saw her faithfulness in the ministry. He saw her obedience unto God, unto the work of God. Say, never be obedient.
Never be obedient
to the work of God.
To the work of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say, praise. Say, neighbor,
be
obedient
to the work of God.
If you don't need him now, someday you will need him. Oh, come on, put your hands together and bless him. Is that right? You said that, be obedient to the work of God. If you think you don't need him right now, if you think you are all that and what? And Becca Church? Someday you will need him.
Yes.
Is that right? If you think you are all that and put it to chips, or Becca put it to chips, someday you will need him. This woman was having a good time with her young husband, and the devil took away her life. But now we're standing because of her standing with God. She has this situation, she had this problem. But thank God she knew the problem solver. She knew that God would solve her problem. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. She knew that God would solve her situation. God will take care of her situation. And thank God there was a good communication between her and the man of God. So she went to Elisha. And Elisha said unto her, what should I do? For thee, tell me, what hast thou in the house? And she said, thine handmaid had not anything in the house. I have nothing in the house. Oh, how often do we say we have nothing in the house? Although you have a peanut butter jar in your closet, you still say you have nothing. You have some Jello, come on now. You have some Jello, the jar of Jello in your house, and you still say you have nothing. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Oh yes, yes, yeah. You may have some debt arise in your house, you still say you have nothing. Because you don't have a dollar bill, you still say you have nothing. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Oh man, I did not grow in this country, but I grew up in Africa. Sometimes we eat a rice without no seasoning. It still fills us up. Somebody say hallelujah. Do you live to eat or do you eat to live? That's the question. Say neighbor, do you live to eat or do you eat to live? Because people that just live to eat, they get overweight. People that just live to eat, my goodness, they suffer from so many complications in their bodies. Because they all live for to live to eat. But if you eat to live, then you learn to control the portion that you eat. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Somebody say, glory to God. So if you eat to live, then you will not, you're not going to overlook what you have in your house. You will know that if you have peanut butter, you have a jar of jelly in your house. If you have a bag of rice in your house. If you have some fish in your refrigerator. If you have some chicken feet and some beef feet in your rice in your house. No matter what the amount, you will be appreciated. Somebody say, praise the Lord. You will be appreciated. But yes, she came, she said, I have nothing in the house. Not because you think you have nothing in the house, do not mean that God cannot find something in your house to be a blessing to you. Amen. Somebody say hallelujah. Not because you think, that your kind of mind, your humanity thinking, not because you think that your weak spirit cannot identify any blessing in the house, cannot identify anything in your hands that God will multiply. Man, God told Moses, what in your hands? Use what in your hands. Say, neighbor, use what in your hands. Oh, put your hands together and bless the Lord. Hallelujah. That's what God told Moses. Moses, use that what in your hands. No matter what the size of it, no matter how the coloration of it will be. No, come on now. No matter what the condition of it in your hand. Use what in your hand. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Oh, I wonder who the Lord talked to this morning. Learn to use the little that you have. The grass is now always greener on the other side of the house. Do not overlook the clothes that you have in your closet. It is your clothes that belong to you. Nobody know how when you bought it. Nobody know how new it is. Nobody know how they smell. You can put some perfume on that thing. But who the Lord talking to here? You can put some perfume on that thing. You can put that thing on your iron board and press it down. And you can put it on. It still looks good on you. You don't have to overlook what you have in your house. God bless you with those things. Say, neighbor, I'm still blessed.
Yes.
Come on now. Who the Lord talking to this morning? Say, neighbor, I'm still blessed. Nobody know how old your tie is, but it still look good in my eye when I see you with it. Somebody, come on now. If that girl love you, when she see it, she gonna be thrilled by it. But who the Lord talking to here? Somebody say, glory to God. If the man love you, they don't care about what you wear. He don't have to ask you how long you been having that dress, how long you been having that pair of shoes, how long you have been having that pair of earrings, how long you been having that necklaces. It is no of no it is of no not his business. Somebody say, praise the Lord. So you got to learn how to value what God bless you. You got to learn how to value where you live. You got to know what to value your neighbor. You got to learn how to value your environment. Say, neighbor, it is your portion that God bless you with. You got to learn how to value what God. Oh, who the Lord talking to this morning? You got to learn how to value what God bless you with. Somebody say hallelujah. It can be a pinto. It has been paid for. Oh, good Lord. It can be a pinto. It has been paid for. It can be a beetle post wagon that is not in style anymore. It has been paid for. Good Lord. Talking to this morning. And somebody say glory. have nothing in my house.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on now.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank God you have the house.
I know that's right. Yes, sir.
Look at the Lord talking to him this morning. Thank God you have a house.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You have a place to lay your head. Thank God you have a roof over your head.
Yes.
Somebody say thank you. Thank God you have a place that you can call your own.
Yes, I thank you.
Call your own. Not because you don't know how to use what's in your hand. That doesn't mean that you don't have anything.
I know that's right.
My people perish because of the lack of knowledge.
Right.
Sometimes you get a blessing. The blessing. Many years ago, I went a loan from the bank. And I thought all this year I didn't have the extra to put down. Till our line bear one day meditating, where would I get this down payment to get a loan? And the Holy Ghost spoke to me and said, go look in your suitcase. Simple as that. He said, go look in your suitcase. And I went, I looked in my suitcase and I saw something that freaked me out. And I was able to put my $10,000 down because of what I found in my suitcase to get the loan. Somebody say hallelujah. Oh, come on, put your hands together and bless the Lord. It been there all this year, and I've been overlooking. It been there all this year. But when the due season came, somebody said due season. When the due season came, I was able to utilize what I had to get what I needed. Somebody said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Not because you don't value what in your hands.
Right.
That doesn't mean that you don't have nothing.
That's right.
Hello. Uh-huh. Not because you don't know how to nourish your family. You don't know how to nourish your children. You don't know how to take care of your wife. You don't know how to take care of your husband. You look for peace outside of your home. That doesn't mean that peace cannot come in your home. That doesn't mean that joy cannot come in your home. That doesn't mean that love cannot come in your home. That doesn't mean that happiness cannot come in your home. You just need to take a little bit of time and get your family the attention they need. Say, neighbor, get them the attention they need. Just take a little bit of time and get the attention your wife needs. Get the attention your husband needs. Get the attention your children need. Who the Lord talking to this morning? Somebody say hallelujah. Just take a little bit of time and give your loved one the attention. Does it make sense to you? Just take a little bit of time and give your loved one the attention they need. Give them the attention they need. The hallelujah, the communication they need. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Oh yeah, you would rather go to somebody else's home to have fun. To sit and laugh with them and smile with them. But when you get to your house, there are frowns and there is, my goodness, crying and bitter spirit. Just take a little bit of time and give them the attention. Say, neighbor, just give your loved one the attention. Not because you don't know how to use what you have. That doesn't mean that God is not available. God is there. He's just waiting for you to present to him the little one you have.
All right.
Say, neighbor, you present to the Lord the little bit that you have. Let God turn it around on your behalf. Is that right? Now, look at what Elijah told this woman. What in your house? She said she had nothing. In the house, but what? But a pot of oil. And Elijah said that was enough.
Yeah.
I mean, this is the same Elijah that dealt with Oprah the last time. Oprah was rich and had everything. You know about the message, right? She was a wealthy woman in the same chapter. A wealthy woman that had everything that invited Elisha in her house. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
She invited Elisha in her house. And she took care of Elisha, but she was lack of something. She was lack of a child. Is that right? And through the prayer of the man of God, she conceived. And she brought forth a child into this world. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. And again, the devil attacked the little child, and the child died. And Elisha came alone and prayed to God. Is that right? And God breathed a new birth into that child. And the child came to life. Somebody say, praise the Lord. It is the same Elisha this woman is dealing with. If God can use this same Elisha to breathe breath, to breathe life back into that child, don't you know God can use the same Elisha to breathe life back into your papa? Or if God can. God can use the same Elisha to breathe life back into your business. God. Only use it for one day.
Come on now.
And he's still alive.
Yes,
oh, come on. Who the Lord talking to this morning? What make you think that he is just a knocking that God can use for one time?
Come on, preach.
Hallelujah.
God for years to invest in his prophet. Yes. Why do you think he's just a knocking that God will just use him at one time and just throw him away? God invested these many years in him. God took time to invest in him. God took time to take him through here and brought him back. God took time to take him through the furnace of fire and brought him back. Come on now. All the wisdom that God has planted in him. All the knowledge that God has planted in him. Come on, who the Lord talking to this?
Come on,
preach. Say, neighbor, why do you think so? That's why people are losing their blessings.
All right.
Because they think that it's just a one-time knocking that God will use and get rid of it. All
right.
Hello? Somebody say hallelujah. Say, neighbor, they're always a next time.
Always the next time.
Oh, the Lord. Your neighbor, they're always the next time.
Always the next time. Tell it.
Who the Lord talking to this one? Your neighbor, they're always the next time.
Always the next time. Glory to God.
Always.
Yes, thank you.
Hello. There are some folks that are so weak-minded. They allow for people to pull them out of the church.
Yeah.
Why are you so weak-minded? What made you think God is not still working with us in the church?
I know that's right. Yeah. Yep. So true.
Somebody say glory to God. What made you think God is not still working with his servants?
I know that's right.
Somebody say
praise the Lord.
What made you think? Somebody say
praise the Lord.
Last Sunday we were in church. And God gave her a vision right here for one of the young lady in the church to do 3-day fast. You got her here. If that fast were not to go on, it would be a burying that child today. If that fast were not to go on, they would have death in their family again. What made you think God, all the investment that God has placed in this bag, yes. What made you think I'm just a one-time nugget? Somebody said, praise the Lord. Don't they understand that the Bible said, he that begin a good work in you, come on now, come on, finish it with, he that begin a good work in you, he will continue, he is faithful to continue it until it is completed.
That's his word.
God is faithful to the word. God is faithful to the promises. God is faithful to his anointing. God is faithful to his children. God is faithful to his prophets. Somebody shouts in hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Don't get me excited. Somebody say hallelujah. God is faithful to his children. Somebody shout, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Somebody
say glory to God. Oh, yes. Elisha, the same Elisha that prayed to God, and God breathed a life back into what he had breathed. Whatever God breathed, he will always breathe life back into whatever he breathed. Somebody say hallelujah. Yeah, because remember the Bible says, many are the affliction of the righteous, but God breathed life back into the righteous and cast out the affliction. God breathed life back into his people and raised them up again. He renewed our strength every morning. He renewed somebody's shouts and hallelujah. He is an on-time God. He is an on-time God. He is an on-time God. He knows how to breathe life back into what he breathed in your life. Is that right? God gave you your family. Just turn your family over to him. The land that I gave you, that a land is a land of hills and valleys. Someday you are in the valley, and sometimes you are on top of the hill. But it is a land that God cares about. The family that God bless you with, sometimes they may be in the valley, and sometimes they may be at the top of the hill. But it is the family that God cares about. The ministry that God brought in our life, sometimes it's in the valley, sometimes on top of the hill. But it is the ministry that God cares about. And then when they come in the side of our voice, come on, stand and praise the Lord. Put your hands together and worship the Lord with me. Then, come on now. The ministry belongs to God. The ministry belongs to God Almighty. Hallelujah. It is the ministry that God cares about. If it was a one-time knocking that you can use, it had gone on a long time. It had gone in the ground a long time. With all of the witchcraft that had come after the church, all of the voodoo workers that had come after us, all of the sorcerer that had come after us, God is still keeping us afloat. God is still backing us. God is still protecting us. God is still giving us victory. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. Amen. We are no one-time knockings.
That's right. No, we're not.
Is that right?
That's right.
Is that right, say neighbor?
We are standing.
Oh, glory to God. We are standing on the rock of Jesus. Oh, Christ, the Son of the rock. I stand. All that ground is my neighbor. I'm standing on the rock of Jesus. Standing on the rock of Jesus Christ.
No,
we say neighbor. Let the world know. We are no push around. Oh, come on now. You can't just push God's people that
run. Right.
And you think there are no consequence for
all
it.
Right. Come on with it.
Just push God's people around.
That's right.
Scandalize in our name.
Well.
Oh, you better be careful. Radio, television land, hear the man of God speaking.
That's right.
Bible says, be not deceived.
Yes.
For God is not mouth. What a man sow, that what he shall reap. Is that what the Bible says? Yes, yes. Touch now my anointed. And do my prophet, Lord. Elisha, I have only a pot of oil in my house. Elisha says, that's enough. The little ye have may not be in, he can have your seat. The little ye have may not be enough in your eyesight. But God take the foolish thing to confound the wise. God take the base thing to confound the strong. God is a God of multiplier. He can multiply the little that you have. Say, neighbor, God can multiply the little that you have. And then I witness you this morning. God can multiply the little that you have. God can multiply the peace in your house. God can multiply the joy in your house. God can multiply, my goodness, the little that he blessed you with. Somebody say, glory to God. He can multiply the joy. He can multiply the peace. So Elisha said, go and borrow. Now, how will you tell a woman that is already in debt to go borrow it again? Her husband left her in all the debts. She already told you that a creditor was coming after her. Somebody said, bless the holy name. Oh, yes, yeah. Here, Elisha, see what Elisha told her. Go borrow. Then he said, go borrow these vessels abroad of all thy neighbors, even empty vessels. Borrow now a few. Somebody say hallelujah. You see, let me tell you something. You listen to this. It is not because we borrow. Is that right? No problem of you going to borrow. But sometimes we borrow from the wrong people. The Lord talking to this morning. Is that right? It is not. Nothing wrong with you borrowing, but who you borrowing from. This is the plan of God for his people. When the children of Israel were leaving Egypt, God told the children of Israel, go to your neighbors and borrow as much as you can borrow from them. Borrow gold, borrow diamonds, borrow as much you can borrow from them. Is that right? And they wonder, they say, what do you say? Go to your neighbors. Not just any kind of person. Just what? Go to your neighbor and borrow as much vessel. Go to people that know about your conditions. Go to people that sympathize with you. Oh, who the Lord talking to? Is that right? Go to people that sympathize with you. Go to people, my goodness, that you know that when you borrow from them, they are not going to come after you. Who the Lord talking to hear. Desire of go to people that know about your situation. Come on, if you have to swallow your pride, and go to that sister, you know that sister is willing to help you because of some foolishness. You and her can't talk to each other anymore. You know she is willing to help you. You know that brother is willing to help you. You know that neighbor is willing to help you. Despite of whatever that ever happened between you and him on the hall, you know that they are not going to come after you for what they gave you. If you can swallow your pride, if you can come down from your high horse and go to them in the name of Jesus, because Jesus said, ask and shall she shall be given unto you. Who the Lord talking to you? Jesus said, ask and it shall be given unto you. Go to borrow. You don't look at your situation. So I'm in debt. America is a land of credit. If you don't know, let me tell you something now. America lives on credit. America owes. Come on now. America lives on credit. Now it's about $19 trillion. Now America owes. America owes so much than any other countries in the world and lives on credit. that how we, that how the system is set up. That when you have a good credit, they wouldn't to give you loan. Come on now. Because that how the system set up. But sometimes some of us go to the wrong people. You don't go to come on, what's the little store in the corner?
The cash
advance for your paycheck, man. You are just holding yourself down because you pay them, they give you something like 50% interest or 70%. You are just going to the wrong people. Somebody say hallelujah. You have to learn who to go to. You don't go to take a risky loan. Come on, huh? Shoot all your interest that your principal. You are paying the $500 on your principal, on your interest, and only $40 going on your principal. That's that. You are impressing yourself. Somebody say praise the Lord. You got to know the right kind of people. You got to investigate before you go to the bank or what kind of bank you should go to. You don't go to no credit union because you don't want no middle person. Deal directly with the bank, because if you go to a credit union, the credit union go to the bank on your behalf. They are just a middle person between you and the bank, and you are paying the credit union at the same time paying the bank. So you are putting yourself in the house. Neighbor, know who to go to. Know who to go to when you go borrow. Know who to go to. Because you don't want to continue to pay that one loan for over 100 years. You're trying to get rid of it and stay nagging around. Because they see you as their money maker. They draw you in. I wonder why there's no more credit card in my house. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Over 20 years, no credit cards in my house. Because I had an experience with Capital Bank. They sent me a card in the mail for, I think, $200 credit card. And I almost ended up paying $5,000 just to get rid of that thing. And for 20 years, I told my wife, no more credit card in the house. We will use our debit card because we know what in the bank. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Somebody say, hallelujah. You don't impress yourself for that thing. Yeah, Elijah told the woman, go and borrow. Do not worry about when God tells you to go borrow. He will send you to the right people, and He will send the right people in your life. He will make the right connection for you. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. This is what favor is about. Say, neighbor, I'm blessed and highly favored. This is what favor is about. Favor lead you to the right people. Is that right? Favor lead you to the right people, and the right people are led to you by God Almighty. Yes, Elisha told her, go and borrow. And she went and borrowed all she could from her neighbor. Not nobody ever her neighbor. Say neighbor. There are some good neighbors. Somebody say praise the Lord. Say neighbor, there are some good neighbors. But the problem comes, you listen to this. The problem comes, some of us are so proud to ask for help.
Yeah.
Yep. So proud to ask for help. Me, myself, and I can do all. I can just do good all by myself. No man is an island by himself. No man can live this life by himself. We all are together like an ecosystem. We live off of one another. No one man can build this economy. Do not allow for Donald Trump to lie to you. No one man can build this country. Somebody shout, say, praise the Lord. Come on, it takes all of us to put in our input. So the problem comes when we are so proud to ask for help. And you know something, they have so close to you. Somebody say hallelujah. We are so proud to ask for help. Say neighbor, that was the Bible say, I look to the hill from whence cometh my help. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. Say neighbor, I look to the hills from whence cometh my help. Say neighbor, I thank God that you are sitting by me, because God has placed anointing upon you. You are too proud to ask for help. You are too proud. Sometimes the person, oh, come on now. Is that right? Sometimes the person that God just allowed to sit by you, there's a reason why the